Recently, Joe Biden went to the movies, and after he left the movies, he ran into a homeless person who he apparently gave some sort of note to and had a conversation with. Now, little did he know there was someone else watching and someone taking photos of him as he was having this conversation with a homeless man. The picture ended up online and everyone reacted to it. So I want to share some of those comments with you. First of all, Caleb Baca, who is the person who took the photo, says the following: I'm not exactly sure what he gave the homeless man, but he appeared to write something down on a piece of paper inside the movie theater, which he then proceeded to give the homeless man outside. And a bunch of different people, both public figures and private citizens, commented on this on Twitter. And you know, everyone pretty much agrees, you know, politics aside, Biden's always been a decent man and a good man. And so John Aravosis tweeted the following, this is my favorite tweet in regard to the picture: some men pay off porn stars while others stop to get to know a homeless man.
Yeah, I love that. My favorite version of that, several people said it that way, is Patrick Tomlinson said, when he thought no one was watching, Trump cheated on every one of his three wives. When he thought no one was watching, Joe Biden comforted a homeless man. I think that is quite telling of their character, at least.
Yeah, it was a heartwarming, nice thing to see, especially in the middle of what's happening in the country. There's so much cruelty, there's so much anger, so much divisiveness, and it's nice to see acts of kindness, you know, break that apart a little bit.
So it was originally shared on Facebook by businessman Paul Equal, and he wrote in that Facebook post, "Character is about what you do when no one is watching." So look, there's the just the awe part of this story. Like you look, I looked at the picture, I was like, oh. And there's another part of that, which is that he'd gone to the movies with his granddaughter. So he takes his granddaughter to the movies, then comes out, sees a homeless man, and spends time talking to him and comforting him. Mm-hmm. That's a double awe. Okay.
Yeah.
And so that's good enough, but I don't want anybody to get confused. That doesn't mean that you have to agree with all of Joe Biden's policies.
No, no. Now you're a shill for Joe Biden. I knew it. You sellout. You establishment shill. No, I mean, this is aside from politics. It's a person doing a kind thing. Let's all move on with our lives.
Okay, but before we move on, I want to talk more about Joe Biden because he's an interesting cat. Okay. I'm just going to tell a couple of fun stories real quick. So Joe Biden will talk to anyone. So that's part of this too. I remember my first interaction was with him was in 1988 when I was a freshman at Penn, and I had just gotten there and I was going to the bookstore to buy some books and shirts and stuff. Mm-hmm. And I was a political geek even back then, and Biden was just running for office, running for president. And he's at the bookstore and he's a pretty tall guy and he's looking around. Does anybody recognize me? Does anybody recognize me? His son was also going to Penn at the time. Mm-hmm. And so I go up and I go, Senator Biden, how are you doing? He's like, oh, great. And he comes and talks to me, et cetera. So look, you can say he's looking for attention, but you could also say that he cares about people. So right. He bothered to talk to me and have a real conversation. We engaged a little bit of policy talk, et cetera. And Biden's also been right on a lot of things. And so he was the guy who said we should have split Iraq into three. I think that the creation of ISIS partly justified what he was saying. I agreed with him all throughout. He was the first one and all, not the only one, but among the few voices in Washington who recognized, hey, knuckleheads, in Iraq there are three contingents, Sunni, Shia, and Kurds, and they're never going to get along. And if you don't do something about it, it'll lead to worse conflict. And it did, mm-hmm. And how that's partly how we got ISIS, etc. Now, that doesn't mean that Biden's right about everything, and in fact, there's a lot of things that I disagree with him now, and I wish he'd, like, he is kind of an average guy, he was the poorest senator, etc., but he stayed in Washington for so long, mm-hmm. And so even though he's a good guy, I think he believes in some things that I think are, he could be so much more progressive on. So I wouldn't necessarily support him for president. But and he makes gaffes. But that was in the pre-Trump era when gaffes mm-hmm. mattered. Right. Now gaffes might help you. I don't know.
I feel like gaffes only matter when it comes to liberals.
Yeah, that's right.
Because they can't shake it. They can't shake it the way the right wing does.
And I love the way he gives speeches. He'll lean in like he did at the national convention, Democratic National Convention in 2016. But okay, guys. No. Listen to me. This is not political. This is important. I love when Uncle Joe does that. It doesn't mean that he's the right candidate, but I will end on one small political point on that. So I see this and I'm like, oh, Uncle Joe, right? Mm-hmm. And then of course pundits come in and go, now look, you know, this is probably a rare situation where age doesn't matter. And then I'm like, oh God, you ruined it.
Wait.
Right?
What? Like,
in other words, yes, he's as old as Bernie Sanders, but it's okay when it's Joe Biden. But those are the same pundits who will say Bernie Sanders is too old.
Oh, I didn't see that commentary.
Yeah.
And everyone just needs to shut up.
Let him have a nice moment without ruining it.
I know, but like we got into politics too. It's just a nice moment. You know, you can compartmentalize those things. Like people can do good things outside of their political beliefs. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, some people can. And some people on the other side do terrible things outside of politics.
Yeah.
By the way, in today's postgame, I'm going to tell another Joe Biden story. It's a really heartwarming story about Joe Biden and Al Gore, mm-hmm. that Gore told me. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's tytnetwork.com/join to become a member and get all the postgames where we tell you these extra stories.